Welcome you all back. In this problem, it is given as hexagonal prism of side 25 mm and axis 55 mm. Then it is resting on HP. So if it is resting on HP, your true shape or polygon will come below the XY line. It is resting on HP with its side and two rectangular face parallel to VP. So I have to draw the hexagon like this. This is my XY line, this is Y, VP, HP, this is my X, right? So now the condition given is it is resting on not side, resting on a corner, resting on a corner and the two rectangular faces parallel to VP. So if a rectangular face is parallel to BP, then you have to draw a line like this first. Then you should draw the pentagon, sorry, hexagon. Okay, this is your hexagon. Now to name the points, this is point A, B, C, D, E, F. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, this line has 4 corners and this represents a rectangular face. Similarly, this line has 4 corners and this represents a rectangular face. These two rectangular faces are parallel to VP. Okay, the condition satisfies. Extend all the corners to draw the front view. So this dimension is 25 mm. 25. So the axis given is 55 mm. This is 55 and you should draw the axis here. So how you will find out the center point? Just join the opposite faces. You will get a point here. This will be your axis point. From this point, make axis line like this. Right? This is my axis line. So now the next thing, I have to transfer all the points here. So this is point A, B, C, D, E, F. So this is point 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, this is 6 dash. Okay, now my simple position is completed. Next thing, you have to draw the cutting plane. So cutting plane cuts the solid 6 mm away from the axis. Then the cutting plane makes 60 degree to VP. Now I have to draw a 60 degree line to VP, in the sense the cutting plane will come below the XY line. So I have to draw the cutting plane here somewhere with an angle 60 degree to VP. So I have to draw a line like this or like this or like this or like this, right? So I am going to draw a 60 degree line. In order to make this 6 mm away from the axis, I have to draw 60 degree line through the axis point like this. Then parallel to this line, I have to draw another line with a 6 mm gap, whether this side or this side. Now I'm making in this direction. So this is my 6 mm. So draw a parallel line with a gap of 6 mm. So now this line makes 60 degree with VP. So similarly, this line also makes 60 degree with VP. So this is my 60 degree. Okay. Now this is your cutting plane. This is your cutting plane. To mark the cutting points, this cutting plane cuts the solid at here and here. Now here draw extend line from here to here and draw a line from here to top. You will have here one point, here second point, here third point, and here fourth point. Now name all these points. This point is P dash, this is Q dash, this is R dash, this is S dash. From top view, the P point is visible. So here the point P is visible, Q is invisible. Similarly, here the point S is visible. So here the point S is visible, point R is invisible. Okay, so now you have to draw the sectional views. So sectional top view first. So sectional top view, this portion will get removed and this portion get remains. So now with H pencil, you make all these lines like this. Right, this will be your sectional top view. So draw the sectional front view, connect point PQ RS like this and draw the hatching lines. So this is my sectional front view, right? So next thing, you have to draw the true shape. To draw the true shape, what you should do? From the cutting points, make perpendicular lines to the cutting plane, and then draw a parallel line to the cutting plane like this. Mark this point as x1, this point as y1. Okay, now you have to transfer this hatching portion to here. Now the point Q is in the xy line and you have to mark the point Q here. Okay, point Q, it comes here, point Q1 dash. Similarly, point R will come here. Sorry, from here you have to make that line. Point R will come here, R1 dash. Now measure this distance, that is from XY line to point P, and cut an arc here, you will get the point P. So this is P1 dash. Similarly, you measure this distance and cut an arc here, you will get the point S1 dash. Now connect PQ, QR, RS, SP. This is your final true shape. Hatch this portion to complete the problem. Okay, thank you.